Hello everyone and welcome to a new episode of Games and Names. We feature in this episode the sport of equestrian, and our star guest is Ali Talat, who is a member of Egypt's men's equestrian team. So let's get to know more about Ali and about equestrian in the upcoming minutes. Equestrianism, more often known as horse riding or horseback riding, refers to the skill and sport of riding, driving, steeplechasing, or vaulting with horses. This broad description includes the use of horses for practical working purposes, transportation, recreational activities, artistic or cultural exercises, and competitive sports. Equestrian events were first included in the modern Olympic Games in the year 1900. By 1912, all three Olympic disciplines still seen today were part of the Games. The following forms of competition are recognized worldwide and are a part of the equestrian events at the Olympics. They are governed by the rules of the International Federation for Equestrian Sports, the FEI. Dressage, or training in French, involves the progressive training of the horse to a high level of impulsion, collection, and obedience. Competitive dressage has the goal of showing the horse carrying out, on request, the natural movements that it performs without thinking while running loose. Show jumping comprises timed events judged on the ability of the horse and rider to jump over a series of obstacles in a given order and with the fewest refusals or knockdowns of portions of the obstacles. Eventing, also called combined training, horse trials, the three-day event, the military or the complete test, puts together the obedience of dressage with the athletic ability of show jumping, the fitness demands the cross-country jumping phase. In the last name, the horses jump over fixed obstacles such as logs, stone walls, banks, ditches, and water, trying to finish the course under the optimum time. There was also the steeplechase phase, which is now excluded from most major competitions to bring them in line with the Olympic standards. The additional internationally sanctioned but non-Olympic disciplines governed by the FEI are combined driving, endurance, reining, and vaulting. These disciplines are part of the FEI World Equestrian Games every 4 years and may hold their own individual world championships in other years. The FEI also recognizes horse bull and tent pegging as its two regional disciplines. Para-equestrian competition at the international events, also including the Olympics, are governed by the FEI and offer the following competition events: para-equestrian dressage, conducted under the same rules as conventional dressage, but with riders divided into different competition grades based on their functional abilities; and para-equestrian driving, places competitors in grades based on their skills.
I'm Ali Talat. I'm a show jumper, which means we jump with horses. And I've been riding at a very young age, and it's been going on for a while now, and I haven't stopped. I started riding when I was 3 months old, and by the time I reached 9 years, I stopped because I fell many times on the same day, so I lost my confidence and I lost my trust in horses. And when I was 12, I started riding again, and it's been going on for a while. Competed at several national and international shows, and it's been going good. I've competed in national championships where I won several shows, including last year and this year as well. And I've competed in international shows when I won some as well, but they were not the biggest shows ever, so we're still waiting until we get the chance. I've won, last show I've won first and third with two different horses, And I've won many places, including first, second, third, and fourth, and fifth, and sixth, in both national and international shows, including last year as well. A good player must be patient and mentally fit, because it's a sport that requires a lot of mental fitness in order to focus and to perform at your best and help the horse perform at his best. And it's mainly you focus on the physicality of the horse. The horse has to be fit, he has to be happy, he has to be healthy in order to give you his best. A good horse in the sport is a horse who can clear the fences, jump the fences without touching them. He has to be confident, he has to be strong, he has to be fit medically and mentally. So it's a bit difficult to find a horse with all these characteristics, and but we always try to manage to find something. Yes, there is a certain breed for show jumping. They're a mix of, we call them German horses, but they're a mix of German horses and Arabian horses, as well as French and Dutch. Usually they're very, very strong. They're very, very mentally, they're very, very stable. And we do not have this breed in Egypt. We have to import it from abroad or breed them in this country, which doesn't happen a lot. Arabian horses are only for beauty, so they are very rarely ridden because they cannot be controlled easily. They're very small, they have small muscles, but they're very, very sharp and very hot and very aggressive. So they are used for beauty competitions, not riding competitions and jumping competitions, because it's not what they're specially created for. Nationally, it's to win the National League in Egypt. And internationally, we have several big shows, including the Olympic Games, the World Cup, and a show called Aachen in Germany. They happen, the team of Egypt finally qualified for the Olympics in 6 years. So we're very happy for them, and we wish them the best in the Olympics, inshallah, next year. My main motivation, I start riding because my father is a rider. But my main motivation is the animal itself. As I said, I've been riding for 22 years now, and it became an addiction. My idols in the game, I do not have a specific idol. I am a big fan of Karim Zoubi, Egyptian rider, Markus Henning, German rider. They are the ones I look up to in the game, because they're very, very professional and very, very talented riders. To join the national team, you have to be ranked among the top 5 in the country. And to do so, you have to live in Europe. You cannot do it in Egypt. But so in order to compete at the biggest shows and be qualified with the national team, you have to ride the big shows, who are mainly in Europe. We do not have these big shows in Egypt, but we're getting there slowly but surely. Egypt has a good ranking. We finally qualified in the Olympics by winning first in Morocco. And it's a very big achievement, because Egypt did not compete in the Olympic Games since the 1960s. So we're having a chance, and a good chance, next year to compete at the Olympics. The biggest countries in the game is for sure Germany and France and the Netherlands. They are among the best in terms of Europe. In terms of Africa, maybe Morocco, and in terms of an Arab country, it's Saudi Arabia, but Egypt has a very good chance. We have several top riders now living in Europe, and they're doing their best, and they're winning pretty much everything everywhere, so we wish them all luck in the next shows. We closed the club for a couple of weeks, but during Corona, but we started opening up the clubs for certain riders. I was among those riders who were given the opportunity to ride during the virus, but we stopped competing for a while, and now we start getting back slowly. So we've been affected and stopped for a while, but everything is going to get back in track. To join the national team, you have to be based in Europe. You have to be among the top five or six best riders of Egypt. So it's a very tough competition because not everyone has the capability to live in Europe every day, and it's a very expensive sport. So you have to be financially independent as well, but it's doable for the riders. I think in order to spread the game more in Egypt, we need more media coverage. Egypt, horse riding is not a very popular sport in Egypt because it's solely focused on football. But media coverage is very important, and the media is getting there. We're getting more recognized every day, so it's a good thing. Prepare a horse for a competition. The horse has to be very healthy because health is happiness. You have to have a good strong with the horse. The horse has to trust you and love you, so he would jump the bigger fences and the more difficult fences for you. And it takes a couple of years of preparation. The horse has to be mentally fit. He must be willing to do the job. He has to be very supple and very strong at the same time. So it takes a couple of years, maybe 4 or 5 years, to fully prepare a horse, but every horse is different. Some horses need more time, some horses are more capable of doing the things you ask for in a shorter amount of time. So it depends on the characteristics of the horses and how good the rider is usually. A show jumping course is built, it's 12 fences with 16 efforts, so the horse has to jump 16 fences, including a vertical, which is a fence of height. An oxer, it's a fence of height and width, and one triple bar, which is a fence of height and extremely wide, as well as a water fence, which is usually 3 meters long to 4 meters and a half. All riders have to do the same course in the same order at a certain amount of time. The best rider is the one who goes the fastest without knocking any fence down. We have many clubs in Egypt who are specified for horse riding. For say a club in Zamalek, Platinum Club in Tagamo, Rawab Club in Zaara. All these clubs are very, very professional with dealing with the horses. We organize shows in these clubs from time to time. Usually a rider puts his horse in the club that's closest to his work or school or home. And we train there 6 to 7 times a week, so it's a good thing, yeah. We have 7 or 8 disciplines in the horse riding, including show jumping, including dressage, including polo. They're very different because every horse needs a different preparation, every horse needs a different type of riding, every horse has different characteristics in order to be able to compete in the sports the rider wants him to compete in. And it mainly depends on what the rider wants to do. If he wants to do show jumping, he needs to have certain horse with certain characteristics. If he wants to do racing, the horse has to be a different breed with different characteristics. So it depends usually on the rider and what he really wants to do with the horse. My hopes and dreams is to compete in the Olympics. I hope to represent my country in the Olympic Games and World Cups and championships in the biggest level. To do so, I have to have the horse for it because it's very difficult. I have to be ranked among the top 100 in the world, which is also very, very complicated to do. But hopefully in the next couple of years I can achieve something for myself and for my country. No, I turned wrong. Left your heart torn. Is that what devils do? Took you so long, where only fools gone. I shook the angel and young. Now I'm rising from the crowd, rising up to you. Filled with all the strength I find, there's nothing I can't do.